Another example is Heinz, who have reduced the thickness of their E7 cannons and saved 1,400 tons of steel, as well as reducing CO2 emissions by 585 tons. And these are clear examples of how businesses can improve their competitiveness and reduce the environmental impact of what they are doing. These are quick wins and straightforward efficiency savings that are possible and practical now. And I think many of you will have discovered them for yourselves in your own, if your own businesses. And we welcome where the industry has made progress. There's still more that can be done to reduce unnecessary packaging and increase recycling rates. And one of the ways government is helping to push the agenda through is by packaging targets. As many of you will know, we launched a consultation on the 16th of December on increasing the recovery and recycling targets for packaging waste. And this follows from the commitment in the waste review last year and is in line with the government's commitment to be the greenest government ever. We believe that the proposed new targets are stretching, but they're achievable, and they offer us all an opportunity to build on the impressive achievements that we've already made. The new targets have been set to provide the maximum environmental benefit, hence the increases in materials with a large carbon footprint, such as aluminium and plastic, whilst keeping overall costs as low as possible. You will probably know that paper and cardboard targets are not being changed. These proposals will deliver an economic benefit as well as an environmental one. We currently still landfill 4 million tonnes of packaging waste, which should be regarded as to be reused. With recycled materials in demand across markets, the value of the material we continue to throw away is huge, and we should be seeking to capture and use these resources. Now, the closing date for the consultation is the 10th of February, and I would urge as many of you as possible to reply and to give your views and expertise. It is a genuine consultation, and we want your opinions. Because many of you here are producing and providing packages to retailers and brands, and through them, through the court hold agreement, through the responsibility to deal with the home improvement sector, and in future, through working with other sectors, as many of you do here, in the hospitality and food service, we are ensuring that businesses play their part in preventing waste. An effective government collaboration with businesses is hugely important. In areas where it's worked, like Courthold, we'll continue to work in collaboration. And where progress has not been so good, we do want to consider other options. For example, progress in reducing the number of carrier bags given out was initially very good, but it's stalled last year. DEFRA and the devolved administrations are working with RAP to try and develop a new UK-wide voluntary agreement with your sector, the hospitality and food service sector, on food and packaging waste. I hope that you can feel that you can work with RAP. It's an imaginative and a great asset for the DEFRA family that RAP are there to work with industry and business. This research shows that food and packaging waste represents the greatest proportion of the 3.4 million tonnes of waste that is produced by hotels, pubs and restaurants in the UK every year. And our new agreement will seek both to prevent this waste and to manage the waste that does arise more sustainably. And RAP will help signatories to deliver the agreement by conducting analysis and research to develop best practices, carry out waste prevention reviews, and collecting data at larger firms and developing consumer and staff resource packs on reducing waste. Now, the benefits of this agreement are both financial and environmental. We predict net social benefits worth £123 million to 2015, including the prevention of emissions equivalent to 570,000 tonnes of CO2. There will not only be strong environmental benefits, we predict that businesses in the sector themselves will realise financial savings worth £76 million. So there's a lot to play for, and I hope that many of you in this room will see that there are opportunities for you here. There are other benefits too, including meeting clients and consumers, growing expectations as to what sustainability is about, sharing common goals with your customers to deliver change across the sector faster than just working on your own, but doing this collectively as an industry, and driving innovation across the sector with support from all four corners of the United Kingdom. Now, I know that the FPA has worked with RAP on the development of this agreement, both through stakeholder events and by urging members to respond to the recent industry discussion paper. I would encourage the FPA to continue to be proactive in this issue and to sign up to those supporters who will help the sector deliver against its targets. Because this agreement recognises the need to reduce packaging waste, but also understands that some packaging protects food and can reduce waste. We were talking informally over the snack we had at lunchtime, saying that we really do understand why packaging has to be used. But we are proposing measuring progress in the reduction of packaging against the prevention target in the agreement in equivalent CO2 emissions. And this means that meeting the target will be best achieved by making efficient trade-offs between food and packaging waste reduction, and avoids the creation of conflicting food and packaging targets. And we want to see more schemes like this. In the Waste Review, we're committed to developing a range of measures to encourage waste prevention and reuse, to explore responsibility deals to raise recycling levels for metal and plastic packaging, as I've said earlier, and we're going to need your help in achieving these ambitions. The findings from a series of trials funded by RAP shows that it could soon be technically possible to recycle almost all packaging material, and including all plastics. And we must work towards making this finding a reality. The environmental benefits of recycling plastic packaging are significant. For every tonne of plastic packaging recycled, between 1 and 1.5 tonnes of CO2 equivalent is saved from being emitted into the Earth's atmosphere. And there are challenges to be overcome on this journey, such as how we can collect films without contaminating other waste streams, detecting and sorting out black plastics. Black is being commonly used as a backdrop colour for meats and what have you, but it does contaminate the recyclate. And a lack of markets for non-bottled plastic. It's vital that we actually get the economics of this right. DEFRA has begun work through its advisory committee on packaging to explore the possibility of a responsibility deal with the plastic packaging industry aimed at overcoming these challenges. This work has drawn in representatives from the waste management industry, package manufacturers, retailers, reprocessors and local authorities. All these sectors are now working together to see if there's a solution that will provide a benefit to everyone in the chain, as well as a benefit to the environment and UK PLC. I'm confident that the industry working together with RAP are the best place to find a solution which will help the UK reduce its plastic packaging recycling rate. We're looking to do the same with metals. Challenges are different, But the opportunities are the same, and we must adopt a similar approach of working together to realise these opportunities. So the Waste Review has set out our ambitions and the framework required for achieving them. And I've touched on just a couple. We've looked at all aspects of waste policy, making radical changes in some areas where the policy is working and trying to continue down those lines. I think I've indicated that I feel there's still a lot more to be done. But it's not just for a single player, nor is there a silver bullet. But if we work together in partnership and work through the supply chain, well, we can work with you and others to translate our vision into reality. And for my own part, I cannot deny that this is a difficult and extremely complex part of my brief to master. I expect many of you find it likewise. But the Waste Review has given us a roadmap, and it's the shared sense of purpose, which I hope we have, that I get from you as an industry, that makes me confident that together we can meet the challenge. Thank you.